It's me again, Associate Professor Tony Marie Burkhalter. Have you noticed that every week we're bombarded with ads that entice us to choose certain foods? We read articles on nutrition, and in the news we hear about foods that are bad for us or foods that can keep us healthy. And our friends ask us to get out socially. Even our mothers have taught us what foods we should put in our mouth. However, advertisers have a goal of getting you to eat their food so they can make more money. Journalists want you to read their articles so they may sensationalize the information. Nutrition news seems to change from day to day. Your friends just want to enjoy your company over food, and your mother's grown up with nutrition misconceptions of her own. So who do you turn to for accurate information on healthy diets? Study this module, and by the end, you should know. But just knowing who to turn to isn't enough sometimes. It's also difficult to interpret the information and determine what it means by a healthy diet. Does it mean you're healthy if you're thin? What about if your cholesterol is low? Are you healthy then? Is there one set standard for a healthy diet, or does it vary with different individuals? With all this information, how do we determine what information can be trusted? And how do we balance our diets for long-term health? How do we decide what food we should be eating, or which food we should not be eating? Well, think about this. How much time do you spend gathering accurate information before you buy a car, a house, or even a computer? You may spend hours researching what's available on the market, determining what potential problems may arise, and finding out who you can trust with the major choice. In my opinion, it's a much more important decision to keep your body healthy for life through your food choices. And I believe the only way you can make informed food choices is by learning why you select the foods you eat, finding out who you can trust to provide you reliable nutrition information, determining what a healthy food choice is, and educating yourself on the science behind nutrition. I've been asked before how a person who's overweight can suffer from malnutrition. I explained that an individual, regardless of body composition, can suffer from malnutrition. Mal means bad or poor. Nutrition can mean the influence of food on your health and disease state. An individual who has a lot of extra weight could have been consuming food to the point where it can negatively impact his or her health and disease state. So if an individual is either under-consuming an essential nutrient or over-consuming them, they can run into problems of malnutrition. There are six nutrients: carbohydrates, proteins, lipids or fats, water, vitamins, and minerals. And speaking of vitamins and minerals, people don't realize that taking vitamin mineral supplements in excess can also cause malnutrition. Vitamins and minerals should be thought of like medicine. Too much can be deadly. In fact, accidental overdose of iron-containing products like vitamin mineral supplements are the leading cause of fatal poisoning in children under six. So hopefully, you're noticing that you need to be your own detective when it comes to determining the truth about nutrition. If you want to see your diet as a healthy one, you should evaluate the following. Is it adequate in all the six nutrients? Are the number of calories consumed the same as the calories you expend? Is it low in sugar, long-chain saturated fats, and other undesirables? Does the average week contain a variety of different foods that meet your nutritional needs? Keep in mind that one dietary pattern does not work for everyone. Although fruits and vegetables are amazing and highly recommended for almost everyone, individuals with Crohn's, for example, need to be cautious when including raw fruits or vegetables in their diet. Diabetics need to look closely at the carbohydrate profile of fruits before choosing to include them in their diet. But I'm here to help you determine what dietary patterns may work for you, your loved ones, patients, or clients.